testing. The state of Indiana is expanding COVID-19 testing to include tens of thousands more people. Governor Holcomb says it's another step in fighting the pandemic as we near Friday's end of the current stay-at-home order. News 8's Nina Criscolo is live in the newsroom. Tell us how to take advantage of this new testing option, Nina.
Okay, Drew, people will be able to register online or over the phone for this free testing option. Before this, only symptomatic essential workers, those in their household, and people with symptoms who have underlying health conditions that would make them high risk could take advantage of state testing sites. This option will open it up to anyone with symptoms, anyone who has been in close contact with someone who's tested positive, and anyone living in a congregant setting. To start, the Indiana State Department of Health, along with OptumServe Health Services, will open 20 testing sites at Indiana National Guard armories across the state. You can see a map of those locations on your screen right now. Those sites are expected to be able to test as many as 100,000 people in the first 30 days. In the next 2 weeks, testing is set to expand to 50 sites around the state, depending on hot spots and needs. During Tuesday's news conference, Governor Holcomb thanked Hoosiers for their commitment to flatten the curve over the last several weeks and says these expanded testing opportunities are a big part of the state's effort to help as well.
As much as we have done over the last couple months, we've got a lot more to do and a lot more work ahead of us. And I know a lot of folks are understandably, we are too, focused on this Friday and what May 1st will mean to our daily lives and our once routines, our habits. We are too. That's why we're working around the clock to get to Friday with those updates.
OptumServe will be handling all the testing and personal protective equipment needed for these tests. During the press conference, Dr. Lindsay Weaver, chief medical officer for the State Department of Health, said the total cost to the state for this testing partnership is $17.9 million, but she hopes a good portion will be covered by federal grants. The testing sites are expected to be evaluated on a month-by-month basis moving forward. We'll make sure to keep you updated as more locations are added in the coming weeks. In the newsroom, Nina Criscolo for Wish TV, wishtv.com, and follow us on Facebook.
Nina, thank you. 8 minutes after 6.